So we have a sort of early history of society. You've got humans wandering around in the wilderness trying to eke out a living from what's out there. And they find that if they bring themselves together and build edifices, they can actually keep some of the jungle out and actually be safe inside. So they start building little churches that they can hide inside, so the wild world is outside, and everything is orderly on the inside. And inside the church, you've got a high priest who's in control, and when you come into the church, you have to behave in certain ways because you don't want the button to fall down. You have to get to treat it with respect. And so they start to build these little churches to keep the wilderness out. Well, some people really embrace this, and they spend a lot of time in the church, and they contribute to it. Other people say, I don't know, that's for me, and they maybe build little lean-tos out in the wilderness to make themselves solos. But overall, the people live pretty well. But they're living in the wilderness. So then I say, you know, let's get together. Let's build a really big church that everybody can get up. One great big roof where we can all be safe. And we're going to call it a cathedral. And they start to build, they develop their technology for building, and they put in the pointy arches so it'll stand up tall. And they do this, and they build the grand cathedral, and everybody who worked on it comes and says, wow, this is really great. We have this big space inside, and now you have to have the high bishop there. There's an awful lot of rules inside the cathedral, because it's really a big building that has to be managed. But there's still some folks that just, you know, I just don't like the decisions about how that was built, and they still go off to their own little shrines and things. And so we wind up with this sort of dream that maybe one day there will be one roof for all the people. But what actually is happening is that almost fades into legend. That, well, we have all of our cathedrals, but they all compete, and we go here and you go there, and we live our lives in the wilderness primarily forever and ever. Now, that parable is the data cathedral parallel, the analogs to the data world, is that we're trying to build this enterprise data system, roof over everybody's head. Everybody can come in. And what's happening right now is people are putting little spreadsheets, little lists of control things. They're doing all these little things. And we're trying to get them all together. And there's always somebody out there. Now, if you read something about master data management, they'll tell you about the technology to build that warehouse, the technology to manage that metadata central repository. That's like your pointy arches and your stained glass windows. What should the cathedral look like? Give you technology for the cathedral. But the fact of the matter is, the people spend most of their time actually in the wilderness. That's actually where you spend, in fact, all of your time. No master data management project ever finishes. You're always on the way. So this one, and new technology is just making the destination prettier. It's not actually bringing you any closer. It makes it gives you stronger drive.